I bless the Lord for as many who are connecting to this prayer line from Africa, in Asia, in Europe, in America, in the Caribbean, in the Middle East. I welcome you, Holy Spirit, for this special day. This is a day of strength, a day of grace, a day that God will give us new insight and take us forward and take us higher and empower us. Just raise your voice and thank the Lord for the privilege to be part of these prayers today. This is going to be a beautiful week. Just thank the Lord for the beautiful week ahead of you. Raise your voice, begin to pray. Father, I give you thanks for this beautiful week, a week full of grace, a week of peace, a week we see the beauty of the Lord. God is good and God is awesome. I give God the praise and the honor and the testimonies that are in store for us this week. To God be the glory. We're coming to the middle of the month of December. Jesus is real. The Lord bless as many that are connecting to this prayer line today. Let Holy Spirit move. Let God speak to you. Let there be awesome manifestation of grace across the waves of the air, in the sea, in the land. As many are connecting with this sound, whether you are flying, whether you are in a ship, whether you are in your office, let Jesus Christ be real to you today. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Let's pray one more time. Just pray and thank the Lord for those who are signing in today. Thank the Lord for His grace. Thank the Lord for the beautiful grace He has given us. As many that are connected to this grace tonight, let this be a day that God takes you forward. Let this be a day that God empower you. Let this be a day that God give us some new strength for the end of year. Raise our voice, pray. Father, I give you thanks for the grace today. For as many who are signing in different areas, different cities, different towns, different even continents. For those in Asia, I just pray for God to manifest this grace to you. I know it's midnight in Africa now. Those who are joining us on midnight prayer in Africa right now, let God visit you, strengthen you, and give you the boldness to go to the end of this year in the name of Jesus Christ. Just raise up your hands, please. Raise up your hand. Thank the Lord for your family. Thank the Lord for your household. Thank the Lord and connect your family to this grace tonight. Thank the Lord at this service tonight. Let God connect your family with protection, with security, with provision, with health, with the peace of God, no crisis. Raise our voice, begin to pray. We come in the name of Jesus Christ. I bring my family, those in Africa and other parts of the world. We just declare that in the name of Jesus Christ, we unite our faith to pray. We bring ourselves under the canopy of the Almighty. We bring ourselves under the grace of the Lord. We receive strength. We receive wisdom. We receive encouragement. We receive increase in our faith. We receive boldness. We receive His unction. Let the anointing of the Holy Spirit flow tonight, oh God, in every home, in every family connecting with this prayer tonight. Let Jesus Christ be glorified. God is a good God. Sincerely, God is a good God. For those who are watching around the world, we begin our prayers in 1 minute. Before I begin, please, this book will help you. This is Divine Favor for Uncommon Destiny. Watching me around the world. So please give me a call. Get this copy, please. It will bless you this end of year. It's time to begin our lesson. Please get a Bible, get a pen, get a paper. Today, we're not beginning the lesson on the books of the Bible. I want to just declare some things today concerning the end of year. The next 15 days to end this year, let's just decree some things, prophesy for our end of year and 2021. We must begin to think about 2021 now. Begin to see yourself in 2021. Begin to create that year by declarations. Begin to bless your family. Bless yourself. Begin to see yourself already in January 2021, going forth in the grace of God, in the power of God. So today, let's begin with Romans 10, verse 8 and 10, please. Romans 10, verse 8 and verse 10. Romans chapter 10, verse 8 and verse 10. But what said it? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thine heart. The word of God is near to you, even in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith. Underlining the word of faith. Yes, the word of faith. We must begin to speak the words of faith. The words of faith gives life. I love this. Which we preach. For with the mouth man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. You believe, you speak it forth, you confess, you are saved. So we speak the word of faith. So today I'm going to declare some words of faith for ourselves, for our families. But listen carefully. Your life can only be as better as the words you speak. So today, let's speak the words of faith. Speak life. Speak peace. So let's begin today. Just say after me, say the name of Jesus. I declare I have divine favor. I possess divine favor. In this end of year and 2021, I have divine favor. Raise your voice, begin to pray. We declare the name of Jesus Christ. I have it. Yes, I confess I have divine favor. Please, don't confess over and over. No matter what you are going through, just declare, I have divine favor. You must believe it and confess it. Just confess, I have divine favor in this end of year and 2021. I have divine favor in the name of Jesus Christ. Just say after me, this end of year and 2021, I have divine help. My help is coming from the Lord. I have divine favor. I have divine help in this end of year and 2021. Raise your voice, begin to declare. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ. We have divine favor. We have divine help. I speak to the every child of God. You will never be desperate. You will never be cast down. The Lord is our helper. We have divine help. We call on the God of heaven. We pray to the God of heaven. We call on Jesus Christ, the Son of God. We confess today for our grandchildren, our children, our family, our churches, well-missioned sons and daughters. I speak today. You have divine help in the name of Jesus Christ. Number three, Josiah family, I have peace of mind. I have peace in my home. I have peace all around me. Raise your voice, begin to declare. We speak in the name of Jesus Christ. We have peace in our homes. We have peace in our marriages. We have peace in the church of God. We have peace within ourselves. No devil can steal our peace in this end of year. Just say in the name of Jesus, I have divine favor. I have divine help. I have the peace that comes from God. Jesus said, my peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth. So we have the peace of God. Just confess it. I have the God kind of peace. The peace of God dwells in me in the name of Jesus Christ. Just say the name of Jesus. I have wealth and wellness. I have wealth and wellness. No eviction, no poverty. We have soundness. We have wealth and wellness. Raise our voice and declare. We're speaking in this end of year in the name of Jesus Christ. We have divine favor. We have divine help. We have peace from God. We have wealth and wellness. There is soundness in your bone. I speak into your system. I speak in your family. I speak in your body, soul, and spirit. You have wellness. You have soundness in the name of Jesus. You have wealth and wellness. We speak that no frustration, no sickness in the name of Jesus Christ. We believe in our hearts. We confess with our mouth. Joseph, believe in my heart. I confess with my mouth. I possess divine favor. I have divine help. I have divine peace of God. I have wealth and wellness in the name of Jesus Christ. Believe it and speak it. Just in the name of Jesus, I have a blessed family. I have a blessed family. I have a blessed home. Keep confessing. Raise your voice and declare. My house is blessed. My children are blessed. Our grandchildren are blessed. Well Mission is blessed. We have a blessed family where good things happen. Keep confessing. We have a blessed family where good things happen. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ. As many are the sound of my voice, you have a blessed family. Your family is blessed this end of year. The Lord Himself bless your family in the name of Jesus Christ. When God blesses, no man can curse. Your family is blessed. Your children are blessed. Your grandchildren are blessed. This end of the year, we speak the blessing. Just say after me, I speak the blessing over my family. Raise your voice and declare, I speak the blessing of the Lord over my spiritual sons and daughters around the nations of the world. I speak the blessing of the Lord upon well-nation families. I speak the blessing of the Lord upon all my friends around the world. The Lord bless you in this end of year. The Lord bless you in 2021. Let it be done today. We decree we have the blessings of God. Hallelujah, Lord. Just say after me, in this end of year and 2021, I have opportunities. Yes, I have divine opportunities to make a difference. Raise your voice and declare. We speak in the name of Jesus Christ. I have opportunities in the name of Jesus. I can see them coming in the north, in the south, in the east, in the west. I can see invitations. I can see, oh my God, doors are opening for you in the name of Jesus Christ. I come to decree and confess, you too have divine opportunities. Take them in Jesus' name. You must seize every opportunity. You will not miss your chance. You will not miss your day. You will not miss your season. God come by Sierra. The Lord himself visit you with divine opportunities. Yes, God is saying, your chances are coming. Your chances are coming. God himself will give you opportunity to break through, opportunity to succeed, opportunity to invest, opportunity to succeed. Grace upon your life in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah, Lord. Now, this is very important. Now, listen, I've been confessing for well mission here. You are the best. In your job, you are the best. In your neighborhood, you are the best. In your family, you are the best. In the world, you are the best. God says you are precious. Yes, God says you are precious. Believe it. Believe in your heart that every place you go, you will shine. Just say the name of Jesus. I am the best. Every place I go, my light will shine. I have advantage over every other person. I am the best. I'm a child of the King of Kings. Raise your voice and declare. I speak today, you are blessed, you are the best, and you are blessed. You are the best, and you are blessed. I confess today, you are the best in the whole world. You are blessed by God. We have advantage in the system. We have advantage on earth. Jesus Christ, our King of Kings, our brother, our Savior, is seated on the throne of heaven. Hallelujah, Lord. Because I belong to Jesus Christ, every place I go with a blessing. You are blessed in Jesus' name. You are the best and you are the blessed. Every place you go, let your life shine. Let grace manifest through you. I prophesy in your life this end of year and 2021, the light shine through you. Grace shine through you. God's face shine to you. The Lord himself show you his countenance. Let God smile with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Just in the name of Jesus, I have people standing with me. I am not alone. In the midst of the world, I am not alone. I have a family that stands with me. I have brothers that stand with me. I have pastors that stand with me. I have friends that stand with me. I look around me. I am surrounded with able men and women of God that support me in prayers. Raise your voice and pray. I declare today no loneliness in the house of God. Every child of God, you are not alone in the fight. Intercessors are standing with you. Pastors are standing with you. We decree today you are blessed with people of God that stands with you, that support you. You are never alone in the fight in the name of Jesus Christ. You know, Jesus Christ, before going to the cross, in the night in the garden of Gethsemane, Jesus called Peter, James, and John to go with him alone. And he was feeling so sad. And he went to pray. He went to pray. Jesus was not alone there. Even on the cross, Mary was standing there. Apostle John was standing there. It's a blessing to know that somebody stands with me. God is saying, you are not alone. God, you are not alone. You are loved by God. You are not alone. Just say after me, I'm not alone. Just confess over and over and over. You are not alone in Jesus' mighty name. I declare today around the world, you are not alone. Child of God, people are standing with you. Never feel lonely. People are standing. God himself stands. Just say in the name of Jesus, I am not alone. God the Father stands with me. The Holy Spirit stands with me. Jesus Christ stands with me. The Church of God stands with me. I can face any mountain. I can face any Goliath. Raise your voice and pray. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ, sons of God. We are not alone. The Church of God is not alone. Jesus, the Father, the Holy Spirit stands with us. And a crowd of witnesses are standing. They are cheering you up to keep going, keep going, keep going. You are on the winning team in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Lord. To God be the glory. Just say the name of Jesus, 2021. I have meaningful friends. I have blessed friends. I have blessed connection. Meaningful business partners. Let God give you business partners. Let God connect you with friends that can pray with you. I have meaningful friends. Right friends are coming close to you. Blessed men and women of God are connecting with you. Raise your voice and pray. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ. You are blessed with meaningful friends. You are blessed with prayer warriors. You are blessed with business partners. You are blessed with ministry partners. You are blessed with reasonable men and women that stand with you to support you, to give you the right wisdom in the name of Jesus Christ. I see good friends around you. Oh my God, I can see this connection coming in the name of Jesus Christ. Let it be done in Jesus' mighty name. Just say after me, I have the word of God. Just say, I have the word of God in me. Listen carefully. The word of God is a weapon. The word of God is a sword. The word of God is our power. The word of God is our wisdom. Just confess, I have the word of God within my bones. Raise your voice and declare, this end of year and 2021, I have the word of God in me. I have the sword of the Spirit. I stand strong because the word is in me. Child of God, you have the word in you. Speak the word. Don't be afraid. Declare the word. God backs his word. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ. You have the word of God. Listen, you have divine favor. You have help from heaven. You have the peace of God. You have wealth and wellness. You have a blessed family. You have blessed opportunities. You are blessed with advantages. You are blessed with people. You are blessed with meaningful friends. You are blessed with the word of God in you. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. But listen, this is very important. You must know, just say, I have the Holy Spirit dwelling in me. Just say, I have the Holy Spirit dwelling in me. Just confess over and over, I have the Holy Spirit dwelling in me. To confess with boldness, I have the Holy Spirit dwelling in me. Father, I declare today for as many listening to me right now, we have the Holy Spirit dwelling in you. The Holy Spirit in you is your power. The Holy Spirit in you is your victory source. The Holy Spirit in you gives you strength. The Holy Spirit in you is a divine counselor. In the name of Jesus Christ, Joseph Fleming, I have the grace of God upon my life. In this end of year and 2021, I have the grace of God upon my life. Raise your voice and pray. We confess with boldness. We have the Holy Spirit in us. We have the grace of God upon our family. Just confess it. I come to pray for you right now. The grace of God rests upon your family. The grace of God rests upon your family. Just confess. Just say after me, the grace of God rests upon my family. Raise your voice and pray. The grace of God rests upon your family. Yes, the grace of God upon your children. The grace of God rests upon your family. Confess over and over. The grace of God rests upon your family. The grace of God upon your children. The grace of God upon your household. Now for those who are here and their friends and families are in Africa, distance is not a barrier. We speak today, let the grace of God rest upon your family in South America, in Guatemala, in Haiti, in Africa, in Europe. We speak right now, the grace of God rests upon our families In Jesus' mighty name, we have life, abundant life. Now, lay your hand in your body. We're speaking by faith. Just say after me, in this end of year and 2021, I have life. Life is flowing through my body. What I have is life. Raise your voice and declare, I have life in the name of Jesus. I have life in the Holy Ghost. I have life through the Word of God. I have life within my spirit. What I have is life. Life that is given by God. I speak to the child of God. You don't have a bad day. You have life. You have life in your spirit. You have life in your bone. You have life within you. You are lively in the spirit because the life of God is flowing through you. Just say, the life of God is flowing through me. I have the life of God in Jesus' name. I have the light of God. You have life. You have light. Today, I speak today by faith. This end of year and 2021, you have life. You have light of God. Let the life and the light of God flow through you in the name of Jesus Christ. This is very important. Just say after me, I have angels all around me. Oh, I just sense it. So I have angels all around me. I have angels in your house, angels on the highway, angels in the car. Raise your voice and pray. I just sense the presence of angels. The angels in your church, the angels in your home, the angels all around you by day and by night. Receive it in Jesus' name. You know, 3 weeks ago we had a conference in our church. And while woman of God came and sat there and saw this angel standing by the pulpit with a belt of gold and flaming belt. You see angel right there in well mission. So I speak today, God has released angels to surround you. Just in the name of Jesus, I am not going alone. The angel of the Lord is going with me. You are going to your job with unseen angels. Just say after me, everywhere I go, there are unseen angels on my side. Raise your voice and declare. I speak to the child of God, whether you are flying, whether you are driving, whether you are walking in the day or in the night, have no fear. There are unseen angels surrounding you, your house. There are unseen angels surrounding your house. This end of year, I sense in my spirit, by the grace of God, there are flaming angels, angels with flaming sword, surrounding your house, surrounding the church. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. The Lord himself shall fight for you. In this end of year, the Lord fight your battle. In Jesus' mighty name, I see angels surrounding your life and your family. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Just say after me, in this end of year and 2021, I have the love of God. I have the love of God in my life. I experience the love of God. I have the love of the Holy Spirit. I have the love of the Father. Raise your voice and pray. I speak today, child of God, we are overwhelmed by the love of God. Behold, what manner of love that the Father has bestowed upon us. God has lavished his love upon you. Let your life be filled with the love of God. I sense right now, let the presence of the love of the Father surround you. See yourself in the arms of God. See yourself in the arms of God. God is saying, my child, it is well with you. God is saying, my child, I will take care of you. God is saying, my child, have no fear. I am in control. Yes, you are loved by God. God is in control. He handles the situation. God takes control of the storms. Yes, Lord. So don't be afraid of the storms. God himself watches over you. Thank you, Lord. If you are in your house, why not stand up, move around, say the name of Jesus Christ. I have victory every day of this year. I have victory in 2020, end of year. I have victory in 2021 from January. Raise our voice, begin to pray. We speak in the name of Jesus. Victory in the morning, victory in the noonday, victory in the evening, in the name of Jesus Christ. We speak in the power of the Holy Ghost. You won your battles already. Just say after me, I can hear a shout of victory. I can hear a shout of victory in your house, the shout of victory in your home, the shout of victory in the church of God. Just shout victory, 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 victory through the blood. Yes, Lord. This end of year, I can hear the shout of victory in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. If the Son set you free, you are free indeed. To end today, please, let's start two more today. Oh, my God. Yes, Lord. Joseph, tell me, I have fresh anointing. Oh, I just sense it. So I have fresh anointing. In this end of year, God is pouring the oil of gladness. The oil of the Holy Spirit. Just say, I have fresh anointing. I am crossing over in the power of fresh anointing. The anointing of the Holy Spirit rests upon me. Raise your voice and pray. I declare today to all of you around the nations of the world, you have fresh anointing. Receive it in Jesus' name. You sing in anointing. You pray with anointing. You dance with anointing. You worship in the anointing. You go to job in the anointing. You drive under the power of the Holy Ghost. Let grace of the Holy Spirit, the anointing of the Holy Spirit, rest upon you this end of year. As many as walk by the Holy Spirit, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. I just pray for you right now. Let there be freshness of the anointing, the freshness of the presence of God, the freshness of this unction. Let the unction rest upon you. Whether you are going to job or anywhere you are, receive that presence. You are sure that there is a divine enabling upon your life. Let it be done in Jesus' name. Now let's do two more. Just in the name of Jesus, I am secured. I'm secured. You know security? Just see yourself in your house. The doors are closed. And there is a storm outside. You are safe. But in Christ Jesus, you are more secure than just being in your house. This assurance is like a baby in the hand of the mother. That child knows that I'm secure. But God himself is bigger than any other person. So God is saying, you should know and know that this end of year, you are secured. Nothing strange will get to you. Raise your voice and pray. Father, speak in the name of Jesus Christ. Your sons and daughters are secured in their job site, in the highway, in the home, in the shopping centers, by day and by night. The hand of the Almighty God is upon you. Just say after me, I know I am secured in the name of Jesus Christ. Now the last one, just raise up your hand. Thank you, Lord. Say, I have goodness. Confess with boldness. I have goodness. Goodness is coming to me. I possess goodness. I possess goodness. I possess goodness. In these last 17 days to end the year, you have goodness. Let goodness become a possession. You possess goodness. You turn around you, you see goodness. Oh my God. You turn around you, you see goodness all around you. Just see your house like a Christmas tree. And you see gifts all around that tree. So God is saying to you, you possess goodness. There is goodness in you. Just after me say the name of Jesus, every day of this end of year, I see nothing but goodness around me. Just confess, every day of this end of year, I see nothing but goodness all around me. Everywhere I go, I find goodness. Everywhere I seek goodness. Let that be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree in your life that God, the good God, do you good. Let the Heavenly Father, the good Father in heaven, do you good. Let neighbors do you good. In your church, you find goodness. Around you, you find goodness. In the name of Jesus Christ, somebody will show you goodness. One day, King David was thinking about his friend, Jonathan. And find out, is there any child of Jonathan alive? And there was one child, Mephibosheth, who was lame. And the king called that son and said to him, from this day, you'll be eating your bread with me on my table for life. What a goodness. Thank you, Abba Father, for as many today, Lord. Let this be a season of goodness. Let goodness knock at your door. Let the goodness come through a mail to you. Let goodness come through a package to your door. Let goodness enter your hand. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ. You will smile again. In this end of year, let God cause you to smile. In Jesus' mighty name, God knows your name. God knows your home address. God knows your need. Let it be a season that heaven will answer you in Jesus' mighty name. Raise your voice and glorify the Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. To God be the glory for this evening. Tomorrow again, same time, but please, let's read one verse and take our communion. We'll continue in this series tomorrow again. We still have like 50 to declare. Just create some things by confessing the word of God in Jesus' mighty name. Now, turn to Romans, please. Romans 10, verse 8 and verse 10. Romans 10, verse 8 and verse 10. We'll take bread. But what said it? The word is nigh thee. The word is close to you, even in thy mouth and in your heart. The word is close to you. The word is near to you, even in your mouth and in your heart. And the word, that is the word of faith, which we preach. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. We are speaking today the words of faith, the words of life. So please, get your bread, please. If you are watching us anywhere in the world, get some bread for communion. It's time to break bread. We do this every evening until the end of the year. And there are many, I want to receive your testimonies. As you take this communion, send me your testimonies, please. Now just say after me, in the name of Jesus, I have the word in my heart. I have the word in my mouth. I declare my healing. I declare my wholeness. I declare my success. I declare my security. I declare the grace upon my family. Nothing missing. I declare the peace of God. I declare angels surrounding me. Jesus paid a price for me on the cross. I will rejoice because Jesus won my battles. Take it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Mm. This morning, I just got in my mind, I see new doors opening. Can you see yourself going through some doors? Doors opening, a new door opening, the next door opening. Can you see yourself going through some doors? That God of heaven is opening doors for you. In the midst of this end of year and 2021, God of heaven is opening doors for you. And believe it. Just say the name of Jesus. I see doors opening for me. I'm ending the year with new doors opening. Just confess it. I'm ending the year with new doors opening for me. I'm ending the year with victory coming before me. I'm ending the year with a sound of testimony. I'm ending the year with grace and glory. I'm ending the year in the power of the Holy Spirit. Take it in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. As I said earlier, before I close, please. If you're watching me around the world, this is the book you need to read in this end of year. Divine Favor for Uncommon Destiny. Give me a call, +1 240 467 0590. And I'll rush your book in the mail tomorrow for you. Can you just take up a hand, please? Let's just worship the Lord. Just thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Just thank God for everything we have prayed today. Raise your voice and pray. Father, I give you thanks for as many on the line. Jesus, you are faithful. Bless your sons. Bless your daughters. Keep us strong and bless our families. Bless our jobs. Bless our homes. Bless our children. Let it be a season of celebration in Jesus' mighty name.
World Mission International Worship Center is dedicated to healing broken hearts, giving hope, and saving souls through the love of God. Located in Lanham, Maryland, we are called to create a loving and caring community for all people, and we are committed to see you grow your faith in the Word of God and to see you happy and blessed in life. We are strategically positioned in Maryland at such a time like this to be available to provide counseling, guidance, and praying, and believing God for a fresh move of God as never seen before. Our heart's desire is to see all men come to the knowledge of the saving grace of Jesus Christ. If you've been searching for a place where real people who have experienced the love and power of Jesus Christ, World Mission International Worship Center may very well be the perfect fit. You're welcome too, where good things happen. We love you and are waiting for you in Jesus' name.